Shepard, the intel you sent looks good. The fleets are ready to go.
But?
Once we're committed against Cerberus, it won't be long before the Reapers take notice.
And the Crucible?
Ready, except for the Catalyst. But there's no way to hide the ships we'll be sending at Cerberus. Once we attack, the Crucible won't stay safe for long. For all intents and purposes, an assault on Cerberus will be the first stage of our attack on Earth.
What happens if Cerberus doesn't have the intel we need? Or they stop us from getting it?
Then we lead the fleets to Earth and we take our chances. But your intel points to Cerberus and the elusive man holding the information we're looking for. And we have the element of surprise. Cerberus won't know what hit him.
I want to make sure we're ready before we commit.
Understood. The fleets are ready when you are.
Commander, Admiral Hackett's available on VidCom.
Commander.
We need to shield the artifact they've got here right away.
Using Garno's data, I should be able to accomplish this without difficulty.
Damn thing's been here the whole time. Why weren't we affected?
Perhaps the amount of time spent near the artifact is key. After a certain duration, it affords Leviathan an impressive mind control capability.
I'd call it dangerous as hell. Ryzen's assistant tried to kill me.
Perhaps Leviathan was controlling him to protect itself, diverting people away from its trail.
Maybe. It just shows we don't know what we're dealing with yet.
Despite the risk, this artifact remains our only link to finding Leviathan. Perhaps we could find more information about it here in the lab.
Agreed. Bryson's team might have turned up something we missed. I'll look around. They were testing the artifact for energy emissions.
And found nothing. Still, I recommend leaving it here.
Anything interesting about the artifact's structure?
It is not constructed of the same compounds used in standard Reaper technology. Beyond that, nothing of relevance.
Loch Ness Monster?
Plesiosaur.
Loch Ness Monster's more interesting.
Interesting and non-existent. A message from Dr. Bryson's daughter, Anne. According to my records, she worked with her father.
I'm at the dig site in the Pylos Nebula. Project Scarab paid off. I've got another artifact like the one Garneau found. I think it could be affecting people's behavior. You need to shield the one in your office. I tried to warn Garneau, but I can't get through. We've got Reaper scouts coming in toward the main site. I'm heading to the secondary base to grab what research I can.
Anne Bryson was attempting to contact Garneau on the asteroid colony. She seems to know something about the artifact.
She sounded worried.
If Reaper forces were approaching, her concern was warranted.
Let's hope we get to her before they do.
She said she was in the Pylos Nebula, working for Project Scarab. That cluster contains several systems. I'll call up the nebula on the galaxy map. We may also search the lab for clues to narrow down her location.
The Reapers. Let's hope we find Anne before they do. Access card. Any idea what it opens?
The requisitions locker. According to records, it was last used by Anne Bryson to obtain equipment for Project Scarab.
Bryson's assistant Hadley. Do we have an update on his status?
He is in a vegetative state. The doctors believe it is permanent.
But the miners recovered when the artifact was destroyed.
Hadley lost consciousness when he attempted to answer our questions about Leviathan. It may have been a deliberate attempt to silence him permanently.
Let's see what Anne Bryson requisitioned for Project Scarab. Water recycling equipment. Wind protection gear. Didn't take breathing masks.
Based on what Anne Bryson did or did not requisition, the dig site was arid but habitable.
Get me a filter for systems with compatible planets.
Based on the search data, it is one of these two systems. Based on the search data, it is one of these two systems.
Anne Bryson flew out on a ship called the Icarus. Can you track its movements?
No. The Reapers have disrupted civilian comm buoys. But we might learn more if we find the ship's specifications.
Any idea if Project Scarab involved Element Zero?
Unlikely. We may learn more from the Project Requisitions Locker.
Any correlation between Project Scarab and these unexplained creature sightings?
Not beyond Leviathan itself.
Does anything in Anne Bryson's work history suggest where she might be?
Nothing relevant. There are specifications for several ships here. We need to find the Icarus.
Which ship am I looking for again?
The Icarus. We are looking for the Icarus.
The Icarus. Here we go.
The ship has enhanced electrostatic discharge cells. They facilitate long-range FTL travel.
So they jumped to the Pylos Nebula by mass relay, then flew to another system.
Yes. Otherwise, they would have chartered a less expensive ship.
Okay, we can rule out the relay system.
Based on the data, only one system remains a viable possibility.
Good. Let's go get Anne Bryson. stay calm. Credits went through. Time to die. Ambassador.
By the... I don't... You saved my life. I almost died because the Turians thought I was still with Cerberus.
Did those marks hurt you?
I'm fine. They wanted me alive until the fees were delivered for my capture. They didn't care about what I had to say.
You kept mentioning a colony in your message.
Information on a Turian planet's defense system. They'll strike soon. But if I tell you which planet they're attacking, Cerberus will know I turned traitor.
I saved your life. Tell me which planet you put in danger.
I can offer a bargain. The Volus bombing fleet. In tactical terms, it's worth far more than a colony.
Or you could give us both.
You can warn the Turians there'll be an attack, Commander. That should be general enough to ward off suspicion.
No deal, Korlak. You owe me the name of that colony.
Very well. Cerberus is going to raid Aphis. They want its shipyards. I'll speak with Citadel Security about this incident. You have my thanks.
I think I know which project you mean, and I've got a Hesperia period statue in Bay D-24.
Commander Shepard, that's excellent news. I'll have it sent to that project right away.
Please do your part.
Spectre status recognized. One moment, please.
Geth ships have given the Turians critical support to keep their military functional.
Now arriving at Presidium Embassy.
Excuse me. I'm Commander Shepard. If you promise to be careful, I've got something for you.
A Reaper code fragment? Yes, I can use this to try to predict their strategic processes. We might be able to save a few worlds with this, Commander. Thank you.
We got your people off to Kuna, Ambassador.
Utterly sincere. Thank you for your assistance, Commander. This is not a debt we can repay.
Were you able to evacuate any civilians?
Yes.
How many?
Not enough.
My wife has just unpacked active duty, and I'm about to get shipped out too. I was told you might be able to help.
Forces appear close to capturing Thessaly.
I think I recovered the obelisk you mentioned from the Shrike Abyssal. It's waiting in Bay D24.
Really?
Recognized. Lisa, one moment, please. Now arriving at Huerta, one moment, please. Now arriving at Ward level, Purgatory. One moment, please. Now arriving at Docking Bay D24.
Officer, someone requested my presence concerning an incident with the Krogan.
Right this way, Commander.
So, Grunt, anything you want to tell me about?
This clown wants to take me to lockup. Figured I'd give you a call, straighten this out.
Commander Shepard, I apologize for the intrusion. This Krogan insisted we contact you.
It's okay. I vouch for him. I'll sign any paperwork you have, officer.
Yes, ma'am.
What happened?
I don't know. Drank a bit, left the hospital, broke a few windows.
But you were in that hospital recovering from the Rachni encounter.
Yeah, didn't feel like sticking around.
Most people stick around long enough to, you know, heal.
Most people aren't me.
And why is C-Sec here?
Guess they're precious about some broken glass.
Before I sign you out, everybody walked away from this in one piece, right?
Sure, yeah, everybody's fine. Hospital's seen better days, though.
Right. Tell me about the windows.
A couple of squad mates broke me out for my birthday, tried lowering me down the side of the building on a rope. It didn't work out.
It's your birthday?
No. I'm tank bred, remember? Anyway, we got some pictures on the Krogan Memorial.
In the Presidium?
Yeah. When C-Sec got there, they were mad. Or maybe they were mad about their car being on fire. Can't remember.
Why was it on fire?
I threw my bottle of Ringcall at it. Pretty strong stuff. Went up like a bonfire. The C-Sec guys jumped out. Then I figured they didn't want it, so I took it. We didn't get very far before they shut us down. Sprayed us down with riot foam. Didn't work so well on me.
And why's that?
'Cause I was on fire. You know, from the car. Come on, Shepard, keep up.
Right, sorry. So how did they catch you?
Got hungry. Bought some noodles.
Grunt, you apologize to the nice man for setting his car on fire.
Fine. I'm sorry for setting your car on fire. And I won't do it again.
Good. Now, officer, I can pay for any damages that may have occurred.
That's what you've been signing for, Commander. You're lucky, Krogan. Don't let me catch you up here again.
You won't. Thank you, officer. So, how were those noodles?
A little spicy.
I love you, Grunt. Enjoying your shore leave, Javik?
I have been asked to take part in a feat. I am told it is a great honor and will boost morale for the war.
Who says it will?
Ah, Commander Shepard! I didn't realize you were coming too! Perfect timing, perfect timing. You can play yourself. Attention! The Prothean is on set! Someone tell the stunt double he's been demoted. We have the real Shepard now. All right, places everyone. Quickly, quickly! Cue the backdrop. Roll cameras. And action! Commander Shepard, thank you for coming. The urgent hour of doom, which we all urgently face, draws near. Urgently so. But there is hope. The Council understands you recently found a Prothean in a refrigerator and defrosted him.
Yeah. He was in the freezer, right behind the Varen roast.
Ah! You die now! Not yet. That line comes later. The Vorcha Counselor will kindly refrain from further interruptions.
I believe I have been misinformed about the purpose of this vid.
Now then, O wise Prothean Elder, what wisdom of the ages can you share with us?
Solarian kidney is best served at room temperature. It is even better when the Solarian is still alive. The fear adds spice.
Prothean, no like you!
Did someone say Prothean? This one is familiar with enkindling. This one has enkindled multiple females across the galaxy.
Blasto! About time you showed up! The galaxy is under attack by Reapers! If only someone had warned us about them years ago!
This one tried. This one was ignored. This one's efforts fell on obstructed auditories.
Actually that was me. Sovereign, Saren, you might have heard of them.
Yes, and Blasto here destroyed half the Citadel, putting them down. But even he's just one Hanar.
And now we've asked Commander Shepard and his Prothean partner here to assist.
This one did not read that far into the script. This one does not share top billing.
Wait, what? But it's Blasto 7. Blasto goes to war? Think of the children.
In my cycle, your kind were nothing more than appetizers. Would you prefer to be boiled or fried?
Prothean, no like you!
This one has found his motivation. Very well. Commander Shepard and Prothean partner of undetermined ethnic origin, welcome to the Spectre Club.
I've been in the club for 3 years now.
Correct. But you are not an Ultra Spectre Elite 4000 Deluxe. This one is a 7000. This one has less recoil and faster load time.
Where is the airlock so I may throw you out of it?
We don't have a prop for that. Cue the sound effects. Change the backdrop.
Look! It's Sovereign half-brother Sluggard! And he's looking for some payback.
Cue the stunt double! Your line. Say your line. Oh, you die now! Oh no! The Vorcha Counselor is indoctrinated!
This one is the hero of the Citadel. This one has an incendiary projectile with the Counselor's name on it. Vorcha.
This one is the hero of the Citadel. I'll handle it.
This one insists.
This one doesn't care.
This one wishes he was still frozen in the refrigerator. May we go now, Commander?
Strike the set! Tell casting we'll need a new Vorcha. Prepare for Blasto 8. Blasto cures the genophage.
Actually, I...
Hey, got any plans for the evening?
No. I'm as free as the dust in the solar wind. You remember that line? From Fleet and Flotilla? Shalai and Bellicus on the balcony?
I don't think I've ever seen that. Vid?
What? You've never? How could you not have? Well, I know what we're doing tonight.
But Shalai, we can never be together. I have my duty, and you have your people.
Not tonight. Tonight, I'm as free as the dust in the solar wind.
So you've watched this a lot, huh?
Every time my friends and I had a sleepover. Kila, so many feelings.
Yeah, it's, yeah, definitely.
When this is done, I'll send you links to extranet sites with some captioned animations. I want you to see behind this mask. I want you to see who I truly am.
I already have.
She had an infection for 3 weeks after filming this scene.
Totally worth it.
Greetings, Commander.
Shepard.
I didn't know you could play.
Actually, this is the only song I know.
Why is that?
There was always something more important to do. A ruin to uncover, intel to gather, a commander to save.
Ha! You couldn't sit still long enough.
Could you?
Is there something special about this song?
On one of my first digs, a storm swept in. We were trapped inside. I was so restless. I wanted to get back to work. One of the other archaeologists, Dr. Olena, had this keyboard. She took it everywhere. She taught me to play this song while we waited.
It's a good song.
Thank you, Shepard. I've always loved that song. Shepard, I... What are you doing?
Making sure you don't run off to something more important.
Imagine what that would be.
We should do this more often.
Yes, well, maybe after.
Every day after.
Shepard. This place is nice.
Shall I transfer over your reports so that you might work here?
Yes, thank you, Glyph. Glyph, can you copy that song to my personal files on the Normandy?
Certainly, Dr. Tassoni.
Shepard.
Thank you. We are gathered here to honor the life of Thane Krios. Thane touched each of our lives in different ways. The Counselor knew him as a hero. The Normandy's crew knew him as a brother in arms. And others, as a father devoted to his son. Though his life took him to very dark places, Thane cared for the better angels of our nature. Even when he was terminally ill, he ran through war-torn streets to reach me, because he knew I needed help. You all know the results of that day. An assassin, a professional criminal, gave his life for his galaxy. And now he can rest. Would anyone else like to speak?
What I remember about Thane was his confidence. He told me once about how he remembered everything, even every mistake he made. If I did that, I'd be a nervous wreck. Thane kept it under control.
It's strange, but the last word I'd label Thane with is assassin. We covered each other in firefights. That makes him a partner.
Thane's last stand was important. But let us also remember why Thane left the Normandy. To keep his son away from a life of crime. Deeds such as these do not go unnoticed by the universe. They echo in all who hear them. That is why I am here.
Thane took himself seriously. A trait with which I did not always agree. I tried to make him laugh on several occasions. But what I interpreted as a lack of humor was masking a great effort. Thane was turning his life around in a way few organics do.
The day Thane came onto the Normandy, all Kelly and I knew about him was that he could probably kill us all with a ballpoint pen. But after you got to know him, there wasn't any reason to be afraid. He let you know where you stood. Kolyat, do you,
When I was little, I thought my father had it all figured out. He said men must be loyal to their friends and dangerous to their enemies. But when he prevented me from hurting someone, he had changed. He said enemies and ego are not as important as loved ones. I didn't want to hear it. I was lost. I called him a hypocrite in a thousand different ways, said that he was going soft. Now, I think maybe he did have it all figured out. That's all I can say. If anyone would like to continue, we'll be here.
Looks like people are starting to clear out.
Commander, thank you for holding this event. In time, it will be a good memory.
I don't know if I'll be as philosophical about it. It's still kind of raw.
I understand. If you will excuse me, I should take this opportunity to speak with the Counselor.
About what?
He is feeling grateful, and I want to point out there are some Solarian biologists who need funding. If anyone would be able to create a breakthrough in the treatment of Kepler syndrome, it would be them.
If you need someone to hold the Counselor's feet to a fire, I'm there.
I appreciate the offer. But Counselor Valern has recently orated about funding science during wartime. My odds are good. Oh, before I go, I was organizing my father's possessions, and I came upon copies of video messages he tried to send you. I sent them to your extranet address. I hope they help more than they hurt. Until we meet again, Commander.
You never asked me about this, but my wife just...
Shepard, I suppose I should thank you for my freedom. Leaving the Normandy was the right decision. It was saddening to see our crew go their separate ways. But it is better than answering questions in an Alliance interrogation room. I hope this message finds you well. As for me, I have moved into an apartment on the Citadel not far from Kolyat. I think the first attack I had frightened him. I will spare you the details. It seemed very dramatic at the time. But in comparison to the Omega Relay, it was a child's game. In any case, good luck getting the Alliance to listen to you. Let's keep in touch. Shepard, if you sent a message back, I didn't get it. I suppose communications from someone of my reputation would be restricted. The irony is, I am a danger to no one these days. I am even paying taxes on my investments. I can't expect Kolyat to do so if I don't. He is doing better. He has no significant other, and he is temperamental. But he is employed and staying out of crime. I can tell he's serious about changing. It has cost him more than a few friends. Send something back if you can, Shepard. I can only learn so much from news reports about you. I have tried a false identity to try to get this message through to you. We'll see if it works. I have good news and bad. The good news is that Kolyat and I took a few days to visit Earth.
Like the shape of her eyes, shrill sound of chirping stops. I scan the ground, see two tiny bodies locked by claws.
Excuse me. As I was saying, we saw a beautiful sunset in New Mexico. And a scorpion eating a cricket. I wish you could have joined us. The bad news is, I fainted and struck my head. Kolyat has convinced me to stay at Huerta Memorial on the Citadel. I will be there from now on. I still don't want to die in a hospital. But it's where the doctors are. And Kolyat. I love him. That means I must trust him. Goodbye, Shepard. Let me say that now, in case I cannot later.
Hey, Shepard. I see you got things cleaned up.
Eventually.
Yeah, sorry about that. Nice view. But this place, it's just so not what I'm used to.
Which is?
I grew up on the beach on the Pacific, so, you know, water, sand, real air.
You miss it?
Yeah. And the people.
So, what's her name?
No. No. I stopped fraternizing when I joined the military. The two don't seem to go well together.
Hasn't stopped you from being a shameless flirt.
Yeah, that's just my way. I don't mean anything by it.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I'm not making things awkward for you and Liara, right?
Not even remotely. So did you really come up here to talk about my personal life?
Oh, shit, right. I wanted to show you. What do you think?
Looks good. And you've earned it. Now the real work begins, right?
Exactly. And I heard what you said before. And I'm in. 100%.
Glad to hear it.
Anyway, that's it. Just wanted to show you that bad boy. I gotta get back to the Normandy. Esteban wants my help working on the shuttle.
Thanks for coming by, James.
Hasta la vista, Shepard.
Catch you later, Shepard.
What the hell? No way. Hey, I remember seeing this when I was here for the party. Oh, man. This is sweet.
Hey, Shepard. You know, my record is 182. You think you can beat it?
Maybe.
Oh, this should be good. Not bad.
Look like a pro.
Shut up, Vega.
Touchy, touchy. That's 20. That's it, come on. Nice. Got a front row seat to the gun show.
Keep it up, amigo. That's 60. High five.
20.
Make it burn. Don't lose your focus. Halfway to my record.
Great.
That's impressive.
Thanks.
Just 82 to go. You go, Commander. Ugh. Hang in there.
God.
Got a ways to go, my friend. Don't lose it now. Holy hell, you did it. I don't know what to say. How you feeling?
Might need help pulling my armor on next time.
No doubt, Shepard. That was loco. Damn, you still got it. Don't let anybody tell you different.
Don't worry, I won't.
Come on, let me just use it for a bit.
I came as quickly as I could. What's wrong?
I didn't mean to worry you. We just didn't get much of a chance to talk at the party.
We've said our farewells, Shepard.
Are we gonna stand on formalities? These big picture windows remind me of our talks in the Normandy's observation lounge.
This view doesn't have quite the same effect as a galaxy of stars, but I can see where it might make one sentimental. I also enjoyed our talks, Shepard. Very much.
Hey, look what I found. An old issue of Justicar Heroes, May 2140. It says that you personally lifted 50 refugees across a raging floodplain on Nivos after smugglers blew up a dam.
That news source has been known to exaggerate.
So you didn't almost drown while saving a child who'd been torn from her mother's grasp?
The smugglers were not so lucky that I survived.
Are there more stories like this?
Perhaps. You might be amused by the June 2085 issue, Justicar Samara, Cold-Blooded Justice Runs Hot. It is not so difficult for me to find stories of your exploits. I think that you are remarkable, Shepard. When the vids sing your praises and call you a hero, does it make you blush? Do you agree? What do you feel?
It's humbling. But honestly, if people feel that I'm making a difference, that bolsters me, my team, and our efforts. What now?
I am content as we are, Shepard. Let us sit a while longer, even if there is nothing to say.
You're sure of what you saw?
Yes, Sergeant.
Heard from your brother since then?
No.
All right, Talavi.
A new notification is available on the private messages terminal.
Hello again.
Hello, come on.